Alright everyone, time for a booze and talk video. I was going to do a cider again this week. I'm still searching for a half decent cider to do a video on, but there's a new beer place opened up, a new shop, and they had some interesting things, so I picked up a couple of things, and this is one of them. It's a bit of a hipster place, you know how it is. Here we go, flat white. A flat white breakfast stout. I don't know about the cover art. It's all a bit sort of, I could say, a bit hipstery. I don't really like that. But so if the beer's good, and also the ingredients sounded interesting. For a start, it's 7.4%. A nice strong beer for a change. Water, malted barley, oats, hops, yeast, milk, and coffee. So that sounds interesting. I mean, I've had milk stouts before, but I don't think they actually had milk in them, so it's interesting. And it says brewed and canned by Alphabet Brewing Co, 99 North Western Street, Manchester, UK. So it's somewhere I used to live, and it's an interesting sounding beer. Unfiltered and unpasteurized, store upright. It doesn't say what temperatures to serve it at, and this has just come out of the fridge, so it's pretty cold, but I don't know, the fact it's got like milk and coffee makes me think of like an iced coffee, you know, you get them in the bottles. I quite like them, so I figured it might be good, nice and chilled like that. And the artwork's not bad. It's nice drawings, pretty good. At least there's no one with a big fucking beard on there. I always complain about things being a bit too hipster, but Alex says that actually makes me like a massive hipster, because that's basically what hipsters do, is they're kind of in denial. They don't know that they are the thing that they hate. So maybe she's right, I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to pour this out, see what it's like. A nice milky coffee beer. I think the main thing that divides me from the hipsters is that they're on the whole extremely politically correct and progressive, and I hate all that bullshit, so you know, I don't think I'd be allowed into their club. It's fucking cloudy, isn't it? Look at that. It's probably the milk, I imagine. Weird orange colour. I was expecting like a black, like a Guinness type of thing. This is not what I expected at all. The head on it's proper foamy and a bit sort of yellowy coloured. And look at the colour of it. It's like, I don't know. It smells pure coffee. Like, it does just smell like an iced coffee or something like that. Maybe if I'd let it warm up a bit, it might have a bit more flavour, but I'll keep it in my hand the whole time, and then it'll warm up as I'm drinking it. I'm sure more flavours will come out, but anyway, let's try this. Doesn't smell like alcohol, like, you know, a 7.4% beer. You'd think it would smell more alcohol-y than this. Yeah, I don't know, I was expecting more of a kind of milkshake taste to it. It must not have a whole lot of lactose. Yeah, it says lactose milk, but I was expecting it to be like a milky thing, like a Bailey's or something. I don't know why. It's nice. It's very, the coffee notes are very bitter. I think that's like, it's more like, It's less hops bitter and more coffee bitter, which I like. I'm getting, I think I said on other videos, I'm getting a bit sick of the hop profiles in beers these days, because they're all starting to taste the same. I actually think I've been saying that for years, but I don't know. Anyway, there was loads of IPAs in this shop that I went into, and I deliberately just bypassed them all because I wanted to find something that wasn't like that sort of taste. Anyway, it's very, very bitter. It's like a espresso or something. It's got that kind of slightly salty, savoury taste that you get with, like, you know, your Walker and stuff like that. The like Polish, Eastern European type strong beers. It's got that kind of taste as well to it, which is quite a taste, quite a flavour. Not salty like a Gosa or something, but, you know, like a, I don't know, like one of them, like that strange savoury taste you get with a strong Polish beer. It's nice, that. Tastes a bit like tea to me. I don't know, maybe that's the hops coming out now. Like a strange mix of coffee and green tea, maybe, something like that. Interesting. Oh, I need to say, I don't know if I said this on the last video, but I keep getting messages on, like, it goes to my email when I get a notification on Facebook, but I've like pretty much just stopped using Facebook now. I've got sick of it. I don't know. It just seems like, I don't like the way they like censor certain news stories appearing on people's feeds. It feels a bit too much like they're trying to sort of tell people what to think, the company of Facebook, and I don't like that at all. I've kind of stopped using it. I've got I get the emails now because people have been sending me messages or putting things on my Facebook wall. Because I get an email saying such and such has posted something on your wall, but it doesn't tell you in the email what they've posted, so I can't actually see what you've posted. I just get messages saying that I've got something waiting for me to look at, and it's like, well, I don't use Facebook, so if anyone's sending me messages on there, then I don't know. I'm not going to see it because I don't use Facebook. And since I got the new laptop, I kind of like forgot the password for a lot of things, like Twitter and Facebook. I can't remember what the password were for logging in, and I could probably figure it out if I sat there for a bit and went through all the various combinations of passwords I can think of or reset it, but I've just kind of lost interest in using those platforms, so it's like I can't really be bothered figuring out the passwords because I'm not really interested in using them anymore. So, yeah, I'm sorry to anyone who's sent me stuff on Facebook recently. I don't know, just sick of it, to be honest. More into Instagram and YouTube. I've started using another one called Minds, which is it's like a social media platform, but it's kind of just started out. It's kind of in its, I guess it's in its beta stages, and it's all a bit of a clusterfuck at the minute, but I don't know, it's quite interesting. You get like a real mishmash of everything, like all these different things. It's like, you know, right wing, left wing, crazy conspiracy theories, paranormal things about UFOs and shit. It's just anything just all comes into your feed at once, which is kind of what I'd want from Facebook, really, is something like that. I don't really want to just have like one political opinion being filtered into my thing. So I don't know. Minds.com, it's called. It's quite interesting. I'm enjoying it, really. It's you just basically just get everything all at once. I think it is gonna, you know, it'll probably be cleaned up over as they improve it, but at the moment it's quite anarchistic. Is that the right word? It's quite good. Yeah, this beer's okay. It's quite, I thought maybe the flavours would come out a bit more, you know, as it warms up in my hand. I hope you like the camera angle I've picked today. It's showing off the washing up that I still need to do, and a nice shot of my bin. So yeah, that's exciting. You also see the clock and the light switch. Yeah, actually, maybe some more flavours are coming through. More of them hop flavours. It's almost sort of like the... It's almost like it's starting to go a bit like citrus hops, like them sort of ones that taste a bit grapefruity. Maybe that's the breakfast side of it, the flat white. You're getting your coffee and then you're getting your orange juice or whatever afterwards. Yeah. So anyway, I haven't got much to say. This I'm kind of sleepy, and I'm having this 7.4% beer. Oh. I don't know whether the coffee in it will wake me up, or whether the beer, the alcohol in it, will make me go to sleep. I'm not sure. Oh, I finished Trailer Park Boys. I know I made a little quick video of me watching it. I've kind of binge watched them all now. It was okay. I still think the later seasons, like these Netflix seasons, aren't as good as the old ones. I think season 3 through to like season 7 was it's like at its peak, and it, you know, it's a good run for a lot of seasons. I think the one, I don't know what season it is, the one where they end up stealing Patrick Swayze's train and using it to smuggle weed across the border. That was a pretty good season. I did like this new season. It was better than season 10. I think they relied way too much on random cameos from celebrities, and I always hate that in comedy shows. I always think it kind of spoils it when you just have a random celebrity appear and you're like meant to be like, oh my god, it's that celebrity, and it's like the acting is never really as good, and it kind of takes you out of it a bit, and it's kind of like it makes you think more that, you know, it makes you realise more that you're watching a show, you know, like the, well, I don't know what the fuck that means. It's harder to suspend your disbelief in a situation where they have random celebrity cameos coming in, and I don't know. They do that a lot with later seasons of Simpsons as well. It's like they sort of substitute jokes for having a celebrity appear all of a sudden or something like that, and it's, I don't know, I always think it spoils it a little bit. Anyway, let's finish this beer. It's nice, I like it. It's pretty good. It's not what I expected. For some reason, I was expecting a real dark Guinness-y type of thing, but like milky, like a milkshake. And I don't know why I was expecting that. Just the name flat white, it made me think of like a flat white coffee, and I was also thinking of iced coffees, and I don't know. Yeah, anyway, not what I expected. Still good. I can't remember what the shop was called, but if you live in Gateshead, it's like if you head from Gateshead toward, as if you're walking towards the high level bridge, and there's all these shops built into the arches. There's a hydroponic shop, there's a nice little cafe down there, I can't remember what that's called either, but there's a new shop, and it's basically like it's a beer shop and a butcher's, which is strange, but it's got some good stuff in there, and they've got this like machine where you can get the bottle size called Growler, which I don't think the name Growler really, like, to people in the UK, I'm sure it makes them think of fucking Lorraine Kelly sketches, and, you know, But you can get a growler bottle and fill it with beer from this machine, and yeah, that's a thing you can do. I've never seen that before over here, but anyway, I don't finish that off. That's bitter though. That last sip, you know, I would probably have not go for another one if I was in a pub. I'd need something else now, something a bit lighter, just to clean the palate. It's very, it leaves like that bitter taste really, really sticks around. It's nice, but yeah, you know, you couldn't drink a couple of them in it after one after the other. So, yeah, thanks for watching and see you on the next one.